Chicago is a really fun city and there's a lot of stuff to do, but don't get caught off guard. In this video, I'm gonna share with you what you need to know before going to Chicago, Illinois, based off my hun and I's recent 3-day weekend adventure to the Windy City, coming right up. Hi everybody, I'm Antoinette and welcome back to my channel. Frolic and Courage, I like to talk about travel, food, and life, and I personally believe that with a little practical planning, you can have the trip of a lifetime. So in this video, we're talking about what you need to know before going to Chicago, what you need to know before visiting Chicago, Illinois. So if you're in it to win it, give this video a thumbs up and let's just get straight into it. The first thing you need to know before going to Chicago is that it's windy. And yeah, you just heard me call Chicago the Windy City, which is one of its nicknames along with the second city. But it is in fact windy, whether historically it's from windy politicians or from the wind from the river. I don't know, but what I do know is that the wind hits strong. So my tip to you all would be, if you have hair, make sure you bring a couple of different hair ties and secure the bun tightly. Also, because of the strong winds, your hair may get a lot of static by the end of the day. So much so that you may need to bring some anti-frizz product, or if you moisturize your hair like I do, I applied a little bit of moisturizing hair lotion in my hands and smoothed it out to bring moisture back. Try to avoid wearing a lot of loose and flowy clothing, because once that wind comes up, it is woof, it is flying up and it's flying high. If you wear jewelry, make sure that your jewelry is secured. The next thing you need to know before you go to Chicago is that public transport is amazing. It is very, very easy to get around Chicago. There is the bus system, the metro systems, all types of ride sharing available. You can even take a boat, you can take a party taxi, you can rent out a trolley, or go on a bike taxi with live music playing behind you. There are multiple ways to get around Chicago and there are accessible options available. So my tip to you would be, don't be afraid of getting a venture card to take public transportation and then use it. If you don't know what a venture card is, then stay tuned because I'm gonna do a whole video on how to get around Chicago, Illinois on a budget. You don't want to miss it. Click subscribe so you'll be notified, and then you'll see exactly how I got around and how easy it is for you to get around as well. The third thing you need to know before going to Chicago is that Chicago has what's known as multi-leveled or multi-tiered streets. I had never really heard of this before going to Chicago, but when I was there, yeah, it's a legitimate thing. A multi-leveled street is one that has one name, but two or three different levels to it. And this can be kind of confusing as you're trying to navigate the city. For instance, we'll use the popular Wacker Drive if you're staying in downtown Chicago. And I also did a video on things you can do in downtown Chicago. It's a lot, so pause this video and check it out if you haven't already. So there's an upper level of Wacker Drive. So as you're looking at street names, the topmost level, or the upper level as it's called, is typically just a street name. So Wacker Drive would be the upper top level. And this top uppermost level houses a lot of your businesses, restaurants, most of what you'll go to and visit and see and eat from will be on the upper level. Then there's a level underneath, the second level, also known as the middle level, or the lower level. The second level is for your traffic and your through streets, cars and whatnot. And then there's another bottom level, which is also known as the service level, or the lower level. That's right, you have an upper, a lower, and then a lower level. And that is also for a lot of service streets or even pedestrian walkways. There are stairs going between all the different levels, so you can access every level, but it can sometimes be confusing. I found a really great breakdown of this on the website lifechicago.com, so check that out. But my tip to you all today would be to map out your trip before you go and pay attention to those street names. Does it say the name of the street, or is it upper and the name of the street, lower and the name of the street, or service and the name of the street? Pay attention to those street designations when you're in downtown Chicago, and then choose your own adventure. And also know that if you're gonna go to the lower levels, you will pretty much not have any GPS connection. So if you're trying to navigate the city and find yourself in one of the lowest levels, the GPS will cut out. Just follow the signs to the nearest street, and once you get up and walk up the stairs to the nearest street, reconnect to your GPS, and then go about your merry business. Number four, there is a strong police presence in Chicago. Chicago is a beautiful city, but to be completely honest, there is a sharp contrast between wealth and race in Chicago that you need to know about. And there is a strong police presence. While we were there, my hun and I observed like 4 police officers in a car that was unmarked, and there were police officers across the street and almost every single corner. There was a police officer right outside our hotel, and when we first arrived off the metro, there were cops roaming the metro, and we were like, what happened? What is going on here? It was a little bit unsettling because we were like, why does there need to be so much police? But don't be caught off guard because of the police presence. There were also just a few instances, not a lot, and a little bit more than any other major city I've been to, whether it's Miami or LA, Paris, London, New York. What we found in Chicago was that there is a little bit more of a need for a heightened sense of what's going on. So my tip to you all would be is to know where you're going and know your surroundings and act accordingly. There was a couple of times where some people kind of got a little rolled up on us a little bit too close. And you know, you kind of scoot off to the side and say, oh, if you need to pass, you know, go ahead and pass. And so we scooted to the side and the person scooted to the side with us. We scooted back and the person scooted back. And I tried to adjust my shirt and kind of, you know, just look behind me a little bit just to kind of see what was up. And the person kept getting a little closer, and then they were kind of fixated, you know, on you. And you're like, okay, this is not good. If you have that feeling, that intuition that says this, something ain't right about this, then follow it. We had that happen probably a couple times, although we were never approached, nothing bad ever happened to us, but we got that sense that something wasn't quite right. Just use your street smarts about you. In that particular instance, I held my hun's hand and to create a connection, because hey, two are better than one. And we were getting ready to cross the street, and so I saw the street light change. So I said out loud and loudly, hey hun, why don't we run to go catch the next light? And so he said, okay. And so we ran to catch the next light. And by the time we crossed and looked behind us, disappeared. The person had disappeared into thin air. There was no car that they went into. Like it was like, what just happened? Like, that was a little weird. Then as soon as the threat went away, we went about our business. It's not enough to deter your time or, you know, make you have a breakdown or anything like that, but it's something like any major city is to just be aware of what's going on around you. So my tip to you all would be to bring a buddy and use the buddy system. If you go out as a group, come back as a group. Because in Chicago, there may be some unstable characters like in any major city, but a little bit more so in Chicago. So bring a buddy with you, know your surroundings, know where you're going, and if something doesn't feel right to you, then get out of the situation as best as possible. You can also look at the news to see if there's any particular events of interest that may or may not be safe for you before you go, and that's, again, a tip that I would use for any major city. Ultimately, we had a fabulous time in Chicago. I would not let that story deter you at all. We just did what we had to do, and we went about our merry business, didn't think about it again. The fifth thing you need to know before going to Chicago is what to wear. And let me tell you guys that Chicago is not, it is not the fashion capital of the United States of America. I said it just like that. Chicago is one of the top 5 sports cities in America. So baseball caps, jeans, sneakers, all completely casual and comfortable clothing. That's what was everywhere. Of course, if you're going for like a conference or a special event, you wanna dress up a little more. But in contrast to what I said about Miami in my what you need to know before going to Miami video, where I recommended, yeah, if you're going out at night, you dress in your high heels, you wear your funnest and brightest colors, and you get out there and you strut your stuff in Miami. But not so much in Chicago. Fashion soldiers, stand down. I repeat, stand down. That's not to say you don't have to look nice or anything. You can still look nice and look good, but it's not a fashion capital of the world. So be relaxed, be comfortable. And so my tip to you would be to actually dress for all of the seasons. Chicago receives all 4 seasons, and you don't want to be caught off guard. In the summer, the temperatures range from 78 degrees Fahrenheit to 92 degrees Fahrenheit, with an average rainfall of about 3.7 to 4.3 inches. In the fall, it ranges from 70 degrees to like the mid 40s, and it's also the driest season, which dry plus wind equals static hair. Back to my first tip. In the winter time, it's about 30 to 38 degrees Fahrenheit with an average snowfall of 37 inches for the entire winter season. Everybody knows Chicago's winters can be a bit brutal, so dress the part to stay warm and stay alive. And in the spring, it's between 50 and 70 degrees Fahrenheit. So my tip is just to dress for the weather and enjoy your time. Number 6, what you need to know before going to Chicago is that Chicago has one of the highest sales taxes in the United States of America. Chicago has a combined state and local sales tax of, get this,
10.25%. That's 10.25%! Wow, that is a lot of money!
How this breaks down is that there is a 1.25% city tax, a 1.75% county tax, a 1% transit authority tax, and state tax is 6.25% for a total of a whopping 10.25%. And if you plan on staying at a hotel, there is a phenomenal hotel accommodation tax of 17.4%. That's 17.4%. And how this breaks down is that there is an 11.89% state occupancy tax, a 4.5% city occupancy tax, and a local occupancy tax of 1%. And if you don't believe me, I have receipts. Literal receipts that I can show y'all right now. Here is a receipt from Fist & Co. where we had breakfast. We have a regular check where I got a cranberry juice, 2 sandwiches, and a side of breakfast potatoes. And yeah, do you see that tax? Look at that added right here. Subtotal $33 and the tax is $3.88. That is 10.25%. One of the things I love to buy when I visit museums is the actual museum guide, so I remember what I saw. And the book actually cost $25. Look at that, y'all. And do you see the tax right there? 10.25% for a total of $2.56. 10.25% in action. We have the total of the accommodations tax. I have all my private information blocked, but this is from our hotel. Y'all can see the state, city, and local taxes adding up to the 17.4%. It is real.
So my tip to you all is be warned, be prepared, and include these taxes in your budget. If you're from overseas, every city and locality has a different tax rate. So the tax rate from Chicago is not the same as it is in Washington, D.C. or from any other location. Whereas in Europe, the VAT is automatically included, so the price you see is what you pay. In the United States, you have to add this additional tax to it. So whatever you see that you want to buy, just go ahead and add that 10.25% tax. If you're staying at a hotel somewhere, add that 17.4% tax on top of it, and that'll help you to plan your budget appropriately. You'll know to stay tuned and hit that subscribe button for when I do my budget planning for a trip video, because that type of thing is included. Number 7, what you need to know before going to Chicago is that RSVPs are required for most top restaurants. Top restaurants book up months in advance. And like I mentioned in my What to Do in Downtown Chicago video, Chicago has over 20 Michelin-starred restaurants, over 40 James Beard award-winning restaurants, over 167 breweries, and a number of delicious establishments that you can frequent and eat and dine at, and it is a foodie city for sure. But as things open up again, and if you're going to a top restaurant, definitely make reservations as far in advance as you can. And also know that for restaurants that don't require reservations, you may have to wait. For instance, we went to Michael Jordan's steakhouse because guess what? Michael Jordan has a steakhouse. And when I checked online, it was fully booked. But then they opened up a series of reservations and I saw it the very first thing in the morning, and I booked a Sunday early evening as soon as I could, and an hour later that morning, the rest of the entire weekend and the entire week was booked full. Couldn't get or change any kind of reservation. The next example is we went to Lou Malnati's to get pizza. We went to one location. They were closing in 3 hours. They did not accept reservations, so we went, and there was a ton of people waiting outside, and we said, hey, can we get a table? And unfortunately, they were booked and turning people away,
even though they don't even do reservations. So then we walked a half mile to the second location, and there we were able to get a table, about an hour to an hour and a half wait, where we
patiently waited with the rest of the folks. So my tip to you all would be to make those reservations as far in advance as you can if the restaurant requires it, or if the restaurant doesn't have a reservation system or even take reservations, be prepared to wait for your food patiently. Whether it's a hot dog cart or a pizza joint, the pizzas, the beautiful deep dish pizzas, take about 45 minutes to an hour to make depending on the size, so you will wait. And so just wait patiently or be prepared to not eat at that place at all. Number 8, Chicago parks are absolutely beautiful. Chicago was in the top 5 of the Trust for Public Lands Park Score, which is the national gold standard comparison of park systems across the 100 most populated cities in the United States. Wow, that is such a great honor to have. So while you're in Chicago, don't be afraid to visit a park, and that is my tip to you. You can spend time at Millennium Park and go visit the Big Bean in the outdoor amphitheater. You can go to Grant Park and see the gorgeous massive fountain. You can go to Lincoln Park, not to be confused with the band, to check out the Chicago Zoo as well as the conservatory, among a host of other great parks in the Chicago area. Definitely check out my Planning a Trip to Chicago playlist where I'm linking this video that you can also, guess what, share with a buddy in case you guys are planning together so you can prepare. In the playlist linked in the description box below, you'll also find what you can do in downtown Chicago. I'll also link to my blog where you'll find these 8 tips on what to know before you go to downtown Chicago. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate you. If you found this video valuable and helpful, please give it a thumbs up. It would really help out the channel. And I will catch you guys in the next video. Bye.